coming up next from Covenant House of Praise.
In 2018, you are coming out, amen, bigger. You are coming out better. You are coming out bolder. And you are coming out more beautiful. Say it with me. Bigger, better, bolder. Watching me more beautiful. Amen. Tell somebody, watching me change before you. I'm gonna change before you. I'm gonna change.
Covenant House of Praise, the place where God orders and secures his blessings.
I want to talk to you today on our theme for the year. We want to continue in this vein. We're in the season of expectancy. You just put anything to what you are expecting this year. The theme is expectancy. Some of you are going to be believing God that you are going to get a house. I'm expecting a house. Do I have some house people here? Amen. Amen. I'm going to be getting my own home. Spirit of expectancy. Amen. Some of you looking for jobs. All those who believe in God for good jobs. Amen. A spirit of expectancy. God, those who believe in God for big business. Amen. Big business, a spirit of expectancy. Amen. All those who believe in God for a good man. Amen. Amen. Spirit of expectancy. A good woman. Amen. At the same time. Amen. 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 Spirit of expectancy. Amen. Amen. Some people are looking for a lot of money. Amen. 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 And do you know that Jesus could also be coming? The spirit of expectancy. That the Lord is coming sooner than we think. Amen. The coming of the Lord is near. Amen. So that's all of that is in the realm. But you know, in spite of all the expectancy that I am trying to motivate you to and to fire up your spirit for you to receive more from God, there are so many people who are living the mundane life. They are living the mundane life. There are so many people who are just going through a whole pile of frustration in their life. There is no luster in their life. They are living lives that are filled with lackluster. Indeed, they come out, and when they see you, they put on the facade. You know, they just, amen, give you the smiling face. But really and truly, amen, it's a lie. They're not telling the truth. Amen. Smiling faces, they lie. They don't tell the truth. And then also, you deal with people who are just complaining. They are living defeated lives. They are living defeated lives. Defeated lives and complaining, complaining, complaining. But God met a man one day. God met a man by the name of Gideon. God met Gideon one day. Amen. Judges chapter 6 and verse 12. Let's go to there. Judges chapter 6 and verse 12. And God said to Gideon, "You're a mighty man. You are a mighty warrior." And Gideon, like he was blown away. Because Gideon, called a mighty warrior by God, but he is not living a warrior's life. Just like us. Jesus is the one who said that greater works shall you do because I go to the Father. Greater works shall you do because I go to the Father. Do you believe that's what Jesus said? It's in the scripture. Jesus said it. Jesus said, behold, I give you power. By the way, it is God's intention from the very dawn of creation for us to live, not to be manipulated, but for us to be in charge. That's when God created us. God said in Genesis chapter 1, verse 26, God said, I want you to have a take charge life on the earth. So God says, amen, and let them have dominion. Let them have dominion. God said, I'm giving you the take charge attitude in life. Have dominion. Have dominion over everything that creeps, moves. Amen. Everything that swims. God say, amen. I'm going to have you having dominion over everything. And God says, not only have dominion, God said, I want you to learn what it is to bring things under your control. Bring things under your control. Genesis chapter 1 and verse 28. God says, subdue it. Subdue it. And subdue it and have dominion over it. God said, bring it under your control. Now, this is not pastor, amen, motivating you, amen. This is God himself, amen. I am just quoting. I'm just quoting what God says. God says to do it. God wants you to live the winner's life. He wants you to have the winner's attitude in life. Not the lackluster attitude. Not, amen, living in the doldrums. Not living down in Lodi Bar. Amen, depressed. Amen, busted and disgusted. God wants you, amen, to rise up and to cheer up. But you see, here it is, mighty people sometimes don't realize the greatness that is in them. They don't realize the greatness that is in them because, amen, they have allowed themselves to become victims of their environments, victims of ancestral, amen, functions around them and generational functions around them. So here it is, the angel of the Lord is seeing Gideon as a mighty man. God is seeing Gideon as a mighty man, but Gideon is seeing himself as one who has to hide and live defeated. Amen. Judges chapter 6 and verse 2. So Gideon is in caves. Gideon is in strongholds, hiding out. He is in dens. He is in mountains. He's hiding out. Amen. He doesn't really see himself as a mighty man. So do we many a times. We don't see ourselves as winners because, amen, the amount of stress that we have been through, we begin to see ourselves as defeated. I'm talking about all around. Get those things to me. Amen. I'm talking about all around. I realize that many a times the greatness inside of us, amen, is not, it never comes out because we keep limiting ourselves. Inside of you, there are great entrepreneurial, amen, opportunities to make you very rich, very successful. Entrepreneurial activities. You know, I went to La Tropical, and I put us just resting on the ground there. I went to La Tropical, you know, I went to La Tropical. And when I went to La Tropical, I asked Carol if she can do some hanging plans for me. I said, how much it'll cost me to do one of these baskets? And Carol said, it's gonna cost you $6.50. And the bigger one is going to cost you $7.50. So I said, Carol, girl, you mean to say $6.50, $7.50? You know, I'm a good customer. She said, Pastor, man, you know, that's what boss is going to charge you to do that, man. So I said, Carol, amen, I want you, amen, to really do it. She said, I can't do it until next year because we are closed off for Christmas with orders. So you know what I did? I went down between Prince Street and Queen Street. And I bought all the pieces. I bought all the pieces. I got the Oasis. I got some newspaper. And I took everything and dumped it on my table home. And I said, you see me? Amen. I want it. I want it. Amen. And listen what I made. Look at what I made. I made it. I made it. This one is $650. Amen. This one is $650. Listen to me. I want you to know that you have creative power inside of you. You got to learn what it is to imagine. Somebody say imagine. And create. Imagine and create. That's right. You have greatness inside of you. You should not be suffering. And that's what God said to Gideon. God said, Gideon, I want you to know that you are a mighty man of valor. You're a mighty woman of valor. But instead of Gideon beginning to really see himself in that, he began to make excuses. So Gideon began making excuses in that Gideon began to complain to the angel and said, what about the miracles? What about the miracles? Amen. That our fathers told us about. Verse 13. Where are the miracles our fathers told us about? Where is God? Where is God? Why have all these things befallen us? Where is God? And then he goes on to say, now listen, God has left us. He has delivered us into the hands of the Midianites. The Midianites were sucking them like locusts. The Midianites were taking everything from them. There are some of you, my God, amen, that man who giving you all that hard time, he's a Midianite in your life, sucking you out everything you have. That woman, amen, is like a Midianite in your life. She is sucking you. That place where you're working that you're not happy in, amen, is sucking you. Amen. They're eating up every bit of strength in you. There is no joy. There is no happiness. You have lost your spunk. No spunk in you. Young, gorgeous looking woman like you. Amen. Handsome looking man like you. Amen. And you hiding. You can't even go out to, amen, to movie town because you're feeling suppressed and oppressed and depressed. Amen. You don't even know, amen, that why the limit is no longer on Frederick Street. So long you haven't been to town. You lost it. You lost it. But you see, why should you live like that? And you have God with you. God is with you. Now, I want you to watch something here. And that is the angel of the Lord. The angel of the Lord, amen, did not answer Gideon concerning his silly excuses. Watch it, verse 14. The angel of the Lord just turned to Gideon and said, go in this thy might. Go. That's what the angel said. Go in this. The angel, observe, he asks all those silly questions. Because God knows that some of you are praying all kind of crazy prayers. And God is saying, listen, how can I answer them crazy prayers you're praying? When in you dwells the power for change. Let's touch somebody next to you and say, in you dwells the power for change. Now, like Gideon, as I was saying, many of you are asking the why question. Why? You know, why? Why? You asking the why question. And of course, the reason why all these things are happening to you is because you have allowed, amen, other gods to come in and have dominion over you. You've allowed all the things that, amen, that you thought that you should be overcoming. You now have these things mastering your life situation. And you're just, amen, just sucking in all that the enemy is placing up on you. You're just sucking it in. And God said to Gideon, he said, Gideon, I want you to know I have sent you. You, church, you are one of the sent ones. Jesus said it. Jesus says, greater works shall you do because I go to the Father. I want you to know that's greater works in every dimension. That's greater works in every area of your life. Listen to me, child of God. According to 2 Corinthians chapter 5 and verse 17, when I last checked it, the word of God says that any man being Christ is a new creation. Old things have passed away, and behold, all things have become new. God is bringing newness in your life. The year 2018, the number 8 represents new beginnings. Amen. Why should God give you another opportunity for a new beginning? Here it is. Listen to me. You have 12 new chapters in your life this year. 12 new chapters. 12 new months. You have 365 new opportunities. Amen. That are available to you every day of this year. Why it is, amen, you can believe God. Amen. For a miracle. Gideon was saying, amen, where are the miracles? God is saying, I want you, amen, to rise up, and I want you to trust me, and I want you to know that I am a God of miracles. Now, not until you are awakened, not until you are awakened to say, I'm going to just watch God. You see, as a child of God, there are certain things that you have to do. And Gideon realized it. By the way, the angel of the Lord told Gideon that he has to begin to make the change. Now, Gideon was a big coward, even though God told him he was a mighty man. He was suppressed by that cowardice spirit. Word of God says he was afraid of the those in his father's household. He was afraid of the people that surround him. Amen. You got to start, amen, amen, stop being so, amen, so scary about life. Amen. The only two things you can happen is either you fail or you succeed. Amen. The only two things can happen is either you fail or you succeed. Amen. But if you're walking with God, greater is he that is in you than he that is in the world. If you're walking with God, I'm looking for some people who is saying, I'm ready to walk with God. Amen. I'm ready to walk with God. I got news for you. Attempt great things for God and expect great things from God. Say it with me. Attempt great things for God and expect great things from God. Now, I want to share this with you. Really want to share this with you. Listen, you have to stop ignoring the inner voice inside of you. Amen. You got to stop ignoring it. You got to stop ignoring it. Listen to me. When Carol told me, you can't get this until next year, you know, because we were real busy. I think I did it better than Carol. Amen. 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 I think I did it better. Amen. 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 I'm giving it to you. That's what she told you? She won this one? Okay. Amen. You coveted. Amen. You coveted. But listen. 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 Hear this. Now, you gotta start listening to the inner voice inside of you. You have to start listening. You see, oftentimes God is speaking to you. And when God is speaking to you, hey man, you just You just live a life of in oblivion. So you're just walking, amen, and hoping for happenstance to take place in your life. That's why you ain't doing nothing. Amen. Amen. You ain't doing nothing. Nothing. Amen. I want to wake you up today. It's time that you start doing something. But the voice that you are hearing inside of you, it's time to start doing something about it. And I remember when I was a young fella, amen, at 14, 15, I wanted to change my school. Amen. And I got fed up with my school, man, and I wanted to change my school. So you know what I did? I went down to Tranquility. Secondary school. And I told the principal at St. Tranquility, amen, no mother, no father, nobody, you know. I just crazy young fella, just at that age too. And I went to the principal and I said, I want to come to the school. He watched me. He said, did you get a transfer from the government? Your parents know about what's happening? I said, no, I just want to come to the school. He said, what? He couldn't believe it. Amen. So he said, well, come. And, amen. I had no registration for that school, and I'm going to that school. Amen. I've discovered in life, amen, you must know what you want. Amen. You must know what you want. Amen, amen, and go after it, amen. You don't have to be, amen, 6 day years. You don't have to be 4 day years. You don't have to be 5. You can be 13 and 14 and start making changes for yourself in life, amen. And God will help you. God will help you. Some of you need to start applying for jobs that you don't have the qualification for, amen. I'm prophesying here. Some of you need to start applying for jobs that you don't have the qualification for because you believe in your spirit that you are hearing a voice. Amen. You are hearing a voice. You are hearing the voice of God saying to you, all things are possible to him that believeth. Gideon, that scary cat. Gideon, that scary cat. Amen. Began listening to the voice. Amen. That is speaking to him. It is important that you listen to the voice. I've also learned along life's pathway that it's not only listening to that inner voice, but it's also learning to not become a man stuck in your circle. Amen. You see, there are many, many people, amen, they're stuck in circles. Amen. And they talk about, you know, the inner circle. I'm going to tell you what's going to happen to you in the inner circle. You're going to be doing what everybody else is doing in the inner circle. You're going to be doing everybody else. And amen, you're not going to be special because you're not doing anything special. You're not going to have a product that is different because you're doing what everybody else is doing. You got to know what the voice is saying, because whatever the voice is saying to you under revelation and inspiration, it always, amen, is different. It may look the same, but it's going to be different. Amen. And people always prefer to go with originals than carbon copies. Amen. You just gonna be just doing. You just gonna become a carbon copy. Amen. Of what of your society, and you cannot create a great impact. Amen. If you remain a carbon copy. No. But you see, the thing about it is that, amen. If I was not listening to the inner voice inside of me, I never knew that. Amen. That I could be mighty. I never knew that I can, amen, that I can win, I can overcome, I can deal with the powers that surround the economy of Trinidad and Tobago and beat them. I never knew that I can do that. And I'm saying to you, amen, as a child of God, not just a man or a woman, amen, I'm talking to you, amen, as children of God. God, as the angel of God came to Gideon and said to Gideon, he said, Gideon, you are a mighty man. And the reason, amen, why the angel told him that is that angel wanted him to start to think outside of the box. Don't think like everybody else. Stop thinking like everybody else. And start thinking, amen, you are not going to remain in the condition you have been in 2017. Amen. In 2018, you are coming out, amen, bigger. You are coming out
better. You are coming out bolder and you are coming out more beautiful. Say it with me. Bigger, better, bolder. Watch at me, more beautiful. Amen. Tell somebody, watch at me. Watch at me change before you. I'm going to change before you. I'm going to change before you. Why? Because. Now, in doing so, God told Gideon to step out. I've sent you. Have sent you. When God has sent you, there are certain things internally you first have to deal with. You see, many times we want to deal with the externals and see the wonders of God and not deal with the internals. God never sent you to champion the externals without first winning in the internals. Because your biggest opposition is you. That's your biggest opposition. Your biggest opposition is what you have built. What you have built already. You see, there are things that you have built in your life, amen, that has become gods to you. Gods to you. You have trusted these things. Amen. People have grown to know you in these things. People, amen, have looked at you and watched you in those things. And you, they know that you are having a defeated life in those things. You know that they know too that that's the cause why you are hiding. They know that's why you, amen, can't get out of the dens. Amen. You're stuck in the dens because, amen, you're still messing. So God told Gideon, he said, Gideon, I want you, my son, amen, to destroy what is holding back my blessings. And that is that you have to replace what is hindering you by becoming obedient. You gotta replace, I repeat, what is hindering you by coming obedient. So God said to Gideon, he said, Gideon, I want you to build an altar. Watch it. I want you to build an altar. God says, take your father's young bullock, even the second bull of 7 years, and throw down the altar of Baal that thy father hath, and cut down the grove. Observe, God says, what has happened in 2017, it's time for you to cut it, amen, to take what, amen, you used to live on, amen, and offer it up as a sacrifice. Offer it up as a sacrifice, because you're moving from 7 to what? 8. Amen. So, amen, the bullock of 7 years old, God says, it's time for you to take that and offer it up as a sacrifice. I don't know what you're holding on to for last year. Amen. That you know ain't going to work in this year. God, amen, as big and as strong as that bull was, amen, in 2017, that bull ain't going to work, amen, in 2018. Amen. You need to offer it up and get a hold of something new. God said, take it and throw down the altar, amen, of your fathers, amen, and cut down the grove. In fact, take it and make a sacrifice with it. Watch it, verse 26. So Gideon took it, amen, and offered a burnt sacrifice with the wood of the grove which he had cut down, and he, amen, he replaced a sacrifice. Now, when you begin to make major changes in your life, guess what you're going to hear? Guess what you're going to hear next? Amen. Guess what you're going to hear next? Well, I'm glad you asked. What you're going to hear next is what you did. Who has done this? What you did. Watch it, verse 29. What you did? Some people can't handle you when you decide to make changes in your life. When you decide to make changes in your life, I want to tell you that people will not be able to have. Some people can't handle you when you change. Amen. They prefer to see you in that losing state. Amen. They feel, amen. They prefer to show you sympathy. Amen. Fake sympathy, false sympathy. Really and truly, when they walk away, they think she should have died long time. But yet in your face, they pretend one thing. Amen. But my God, and when you decide to make major changes in your life, I got news for you. Amen. You and God is going to work it out. And as long as you submit yourself to God, as long as you become obedient to God, guess what? Again, I'm glad you asked. Amen. Deuteronomy chapter 28 and verse 1. The word of God says, one, I'm going to set you on high. I am going to set you on high above all the nations of the earth. Amen. Some of you are going to be a wonder. Amen. 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 Get ready to tell your neighbors to get sunglasses. The people around you to get sunglasses. Amen. The reason why they need to get sunglasses is because your future is going to be so bright. Amen. That they have to get sunglasses. Amen. To look at what God is going to be doing in your life. Amen. Somebody just touch somebody next to you and say, watch me change. Watch me change right before your eyes. Watch me change. Watch me change. Amen. You begin to obey God. God says, I'll cause verse 2. Watch it, verse 2. God says, I'll cause my blessings, amen, to come upon you. Amen. God gonna bless you so much that blessings gonna come upon you. Amen. Some of you gonna eat your heart out when I start my flower business. Amen. 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 I took about 10 minutes or less to do this. Amen. It's worth $750. It got 24 hours in the day. Can you imagine? 24 hours of the day, and you begin to see, watch it out there. Watch the next one. When you begin to see, hey, I begin to make all kinds. When I start my business, amen, it's gonna blow your mind. Amen. I tell you, amen, you got creativity inside of you, you got greatness inside of you. You gotta stop, amen, disbelieving yourself. You can do it. You can do it all in the back. Watch it on the back there. Amen. Amen. Please, amen. Don't rush. Amen. 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 Gabriel is my accountant. Amen. He's taking the information. Amen. You can put in your order. You see, you have to realize. You have to realize that God is dependent on your next move. The people are going to disappoint you. But don't let people's disappointments, amen, keep you stuck. You gotta just bypass them and say, hey, amen. They have failed me. Don't get, amen. It's gonna be all right. Amen. 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 Hey, they're gonna disappoint you, but God is gonna be with you. Come on and say, God is gonna be with me. God is gonna be with me. Come on and confess it. God is gonna be with me. Come on and confess it. God is gonna be with me. It's gonna be with me. Three things quickly and I stop. Three things. One. Watch it, Jesus. Watch it, Jesus. I'm going to just slow it down a little bit. Let's take a look at John chapter 6 and verse 6. Let's look at verse 5 first. John chapter 6 and verse 5. When Jesus lifted up his eyes and saw a great company come unto him, he said unto Philip, when shall we buy bread that these may eat? Now, when you read later on, you realize that the company had 5,000 men. You know, 5,000 men? Hungry men. 5,000. I'm not talking about women who look in there, watching their figure. Amen. You're starving and you're watching your figure. Men don't have that to worry. Amen. 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 They could be, amen. Amen. They may pull up, amen, like, amen, like some kind of rubber ball. Amen. They couldn't care less. They're going to still eat, brother. Amen. Amen. But here it is, 5,000 men plus women and children. And Jesus is saying to Philip, he said, what can you get bread to feed so many people? And the word of God says in verse 6, Jesus said this only to test Philip.
Because Jesus knew exactly where the money was going to be coming from, that they're going to come IT McLeod in your life who never knew you. God has people in the right places for you, you know. Amen. Amen. She may not be here or he may not be here. But you see, in 2017, I know some of you had enough of just waiting. Amen. Amen. You're looking for, oh Lord, amen. You're looking for God to make a move. Amen. That God will bring you into the place, amen, of suitable helpers. God is going to send suitable helpers around you. Yes, right. And that's what God did. The word of God says that when that was happening, amen, the disciples, when Jesus said that, amen, what will you do to feed 5,000 people? And the disciples said in verse 9, let's take a look first at verse 9. The disciples said, look, there's a boy here. Who has a boy's meal? That's a small meal. That boy was eating well too, because we have 5 loaves. Amen. I've been to Israel. I know what a loaf is like. And that boy, hey, amen, he must be one little fat little boy. Amen. He had 5 loaves and 2 small fishes. I don't like the emphasis too much on John. John says small fishes. The other writers in the epistles, as you know, the epistles are called synoptic epistles because they're very similar. They didn't put no small, but John put small. John wanted to let you know, amen, that, amen, when you have small stuff, amen, don't get frustrated with small stuff, because God can work with small stuff. Amen. God, amen. Just touch somebody next to you and say, God can work with small stuff. Amen. Amen. The disciples didn't know that before. In fact, because they said, what are these among so many? And you're facing this year with some, amen, with little. Some of you are facing this year, my God. And you're saying, I don't really have anything. But you got to say, look at the small stuff you have. Small stuff. There's a lad with 5 loaves and 2 small fishes. But what are these among so many? And Jesus said, I'm going to let you open a company. 100 companies today you're going to open. And Jesus said, I want you, amen, to tell the people to sit down in groups of 50. If my maths is still what it used to be. Amen. 50 by 100 is 5,000. So Jesus was showing them how they could multiply what they were doing with small stuff. I want you this year, amen, not to live in a place called stuck any longer. Don't live in a place called stuck. Begin to listen to the inner voice. Begin to listen, start listening to the inner voice, and stop allowing yourself to allow the horse and the dog. You know, I'm a dog's boy. Horse. I tell my son, I say, listen to me. Amen. They are not human beings when you call them like that. Amen. The last time I checked, amen, the components of a human being is that he has 3 principal things. He has intellect, he has will, and he has feelings. I said, with an animal, all he has is feelings and a will. Because a dog let go and he wants to come to bite you, he's going to rush past you. That's why I don't trust people when they're telling me, oh, look out here, boy, come. Look out here, come. You have a dog. You got a dog, brother. Hold your dog. I'm not coming until you tie your dog or you put your dog up. Because if that dog want to bite me, can pull away from your hand and come and bite me. Don't tell me come. Amen. That dog has no intellect. He's not going to say that there's a pastor. He's a good pastor. The dog is not going to think like that. He's going to bite me. Amen. So you gotta amen. So that amen. So you gotta realize that you ain't no animal. You gotta amen. God has created you at a higher level. You are functioning at a higher level. Stop living at a lower level. So Jesus said, John chapter 6 and verse 5, Jesus told them about the situation. It's a big company that you have to deal with. But Jesus said it, verse 6, so he could test them. He could prove them because he knew what he would do. Jesus knew what he would do. I'm going to stop here because I don't like keeping you in church too long. Amen. I know when we have enough. Amen. So we could continue. Amen. But Jesus said, listen to me. I want you to know we're going to fix this. We're going to fix as great as the problems are in your life. That's what God told Gideon. Gideon, as great as the problems and the Midianites are taking away everything like locusts out of your life, we're going to change that. All those who are ready to see God change things in their lives, come on. Stand on your feet. Amen. We want to see God change things. Amen. We want to believe God. Amen. We want to believe God. Amen. To change things. Come on. I want you to start reaching out to God. We got so much today. Amen. We got so much today. Let's believe God. We're going to believe God. Come on, church. I want you to, amen, go for God. We're going to believe God. Come on, go for God. We're going to believe God and he's going to fix things. He's going to change things. Hallelujah. He's going to fix things. He's going to change things. My God is able. My God is awesome. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. My God is awesome. Come on, church, don't wait for me. You heard enough, amen, to want to run. You heard enough. You should be wanting to run right now. Amen, I'm ready to run. Amen. I'm ready for a move of God. I'm ready to hear that voice. I'm ready to cut ties. Amen, I'm ready to cut ties. I'm ready to cut ties. I'm ready to run. I'm ready to run. I'm ready to see God take what I have because he knows what he's going to do. God, listen to me. I prophesy on you right now that, amen, God already has it set up. There is a setup on your behalf. There is a setup on your behalf. There is a setup. There is a setup on your behalf. God is about to change it. God is about to rearrange it. Amen. Amen. I want you to raise your hands and call in what you need to call in. Name what you need to name. Call it in. Name it because it's yours. It's yours. Amen. It's yours. Come on, church. Come on, church. Come on and believe God for one another here today. Amen. Look at your own situation. Amen. You're not looking for the undertaker. You are looking for the upper taker. Come on, you believe in God. That God is going to wreck what the devil, amen, wants to put to stop your blessing. God is going to wreck it. Amen. You are going to change things. People will be asking the question, amen, who did such a thing? Who did such a thing? It will be you. When they look around and they can't find nobody to point to, then they will discover it's you. It is you who did it. You and God made the difference. Amen. Somebody say, I am God. I am God is going to make a difference. Come on and confess it. Amen. I'm ready to run with God. I'm ready to work with God. I'm ready, amen, for great things. Great things to happen. Great things. Great things are going to happen. Great things are going to happen for you. Great things are going to happen for you. In the name of Jesus. 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 Amen. There's a young lady who was in the service yesterday. As you know, we have Saturday service and Sunday service. Amen. Can you just pick up that before I step in it, please? And she came, when she first came to church, amen, she was a normal worker in her business, in the business where she worked. And she had no car, she had no house, nothing. And she came, and she came to church one Sunday, and she was so frustrated that she did one of the most craziest things I ever see anybody did. She went home, and when she got home, she called back the church after church was over. I happened to walk in the church office the same time when she called. And I picked up the phone, and I said, "Hello, Covenant House of Praise." And she said, "You sound like the man who was just preaching." I said, "Yes." She said, "I was just in your church." I said, "Why is this woman acting so hostile?" "I was just in your church." I said, "So?" She said, I came to your church and I got nothing. I said, "Lord Jesus." She said, "I came in that service and I got nothing. So I just called to tell you if you could just organize your service so I could get something whenever I would ever come back." I said, "Lord Jesus, this is a Sintan's case I'm dealing with here." And she said to me, so I said, "Listen to me, can I speak with you? Amen. On Tuesday, I got an office there on Tuesday. Come speak with me." She came to the office, and when she came to the office and she sat down, I started to talk to her, and she broke down in tears. And she began telling me how her husband was on drugs and he was stealing down to even the stove, gas tank out of the house, all her jewelry, everything. She had lost everything. She said, "I would go in a car and take a seat behind the driver. And when I sit behind the driver, the reason why I take that seat, I would take no car except I get that seat. And nobody dare push me around, running from the opposite side." He said, "Because that seat was my Christ seat in a taxi going home. I used to stay behind that driver, looking out as not on the road, but on the other cars, so nobody would see me that easily. And I would cry my way to work, and I'd cry my way home. Every day, I go nowhere, I stay home and cry." She said, "That has been my life. I'm suicidal." And she said, "Somebody told me come to the church, so I came." She said, "Pastor, and I am a sick woman. I want to die." And I said, "No, you need to serve God." I said, "You need to serve God. Promise me you'll come back to the church." She came back to the church, and we counseled her. We began counseling her. Amen. My wife and myself became good friends of her. She began to get a promotion in the job. She got a car. She got a car. She came. Amen. Got a house. Came available. And she told us about the house. When she told us about the house, amen, a friend of hers, amen, helped her, amen, and she got the deposit for the house, and she got the house. When she got the house, amen, a handsome young man passed by, and she got a man. Amen. That man is now her husband. Amen. They are two of the most dynamic people I have come across as friends. Amen. They are amazingly upbeat. Amen. Their life has taken a whole 365-degree turnaround. Amen. God turned it around completely for them. They told me recently, they say, "Pastor, stop saying a 365. They say what we got is a 180. I want everybody to turn that way. Everybody turn that way. Those of you this way, turn that way. Those on this side, turn that way. Those of you on that side, turn that next way. Amen. Amen. Those of you, turn that way. Amen. Those of you there, stay there and turn that way. In the back there, you turn that way. Amen. The back. Turn that way. You turn that way. Amen. 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 You all turn that. We all turn this way. Listen to me. Amen. I want you to turn back now where you were. Amen. Turn back where you were. That's amen. That's a 180-degree turn. You were once in an opposite direction. You are now turning into a new direction. Tell everybody around you, amen, I'm not making full circle anymore. I'm going in a straight direction. I'm going in the opposite direction of life. God is leading you into an opposite
in direction. What is in the past is in the past. What is in the past is in the past. Get ready for the present. Get ready for the new. Get ready for new beginnings. God is doing it for you today. Lift your hands and give God praise. Hallelujah. Give Him praise. Give Him praise. Give Him praise. Give Him praise. Hallelujah. Give Him praise. Give Him praise. Ah. Give Him praise. It's a new season. Anointing. Raise your spirits for fresh anointing. Fresh anointing is coming your way. Not the old stuff. Not the old stuff. Not the old stuff. Fresh anointing. Fresh anointing. Fresh anointing. I bless you. I bless you, church. I'm believing God with you. I'm believing God with you. I speak wellness into your life. I speak favor on your life. I speak success on your life. I speak prosperity on your life. I pray God bring forth new things, man. I bless you. No more yesterday. Today, fresh manner.